It was a dark and stormy night in 1941, as George Beadle and Edward Tatum were searching for their next groundbreaking discovery. Pause. This isn't your typical science comic about spacecrafts and superbugs, although it may be just as exhilarating. But before we delve in, let's flip back to the early 20th century. Genes were not well understood at this time, be it their chemical composition, the components they controlled, or even their actions. All that was known was that they controlled the expression of visible traits, like eye color. They were also thought to control certain pathways in biochemical processes, either by acting as enzymes or by determining the characteristics of enzymes. Fast forward to 1941, Beadle and Tatum wanted to know if and how genes controlled biochemical processes. They initially proposed the idea that each gene codes for a single enzyme that controls a particular step in a metabolic pathway. They thought that if they could cause gene mutations that destroyed certain enzymes, and therefore certain pathways, the organism would not grow. After searching far and wide for their lead character, Beadle and Tatum found bread mold, or Neurospora crassa. Not only does it have a short life cycle, but it is prototrophic, meaning it can grow on a minimal medium which lacks most nutrients. Beadle and Tatum used X-rays to cause mutations in the genes of Neurospora spores, and then transferred these irradiated spores to the complete medium. This medium had many products that the spores could normally make themselves for their survival. And so, the mutants grew. However, when transferred to the minimal medium that required the mutants to make these products themselves, some could not grow. But why? Turns out the mutations prevented these mutant strains from being able to produce an important molecule to perform necessary chemical reactions. Later, to determine exactly which substance these mutants could not produce, essential products like amino acids, vitamins, and glucose were introduced to their minimal media. Glucose replaced the more complex carbon source, sucrose. This time, three mutant strains were found to grow on the complete medium, but not on the minimal medium. The first could not produce vitamin B6, the second B1, and the third B10, or para-aminobenzoic acid. These mutant strains grew on the minimal medium when the missing component was added. It was thus made clear that these genes coded for proteins essential for the survival of Neurospora. This finding that a gene mutation causes the need for a single molecule was used as evidence for the one gene, one enzyme hypothesis. This remarkable finding was shocking to others, especially Max Delbruck, who suggested that this method of selecting mutants will exclude most mutants with complex functions because such mutations are often deadly. However, this concept was later scientifically refuted by Norman Horowitz's work with temperature-sensitive mutants, which showed that most isolated mutants had single functions. This experiment not only confirmed the one gene, one enzyme hypothesis, but also introduced a method of making and selecting mutants that allowed scientists to use genetics and molecular biology to study a variety of biological processes. It suggested a simple connection between genes and the traits they control. It also illustrated how useful microorganisms like Neurospora could be in biochemical experiments, and how to use radiation to cause mutations within biochemical pathways involved in the making of important molecules. This hypothesis has significantly evolved since the 1940s. In fact, we now know that genes also code for non-enzymatic proteins, like hemoglobin and insulin, and that many proteins contain several polypeptides, each coded by a different gene. Genes can also produce several types of known coding RNAs, like ribosomal and transfer RNA. And the process of alternative splicing makes multiple proteins from one gene. However, none of this would have been possible if not for Beadle and Tatum's revolutionary experiment. Following their Nobel Prize-winning finding, Beadle retired from experimental science, but conducted studies on corn, while Tatum expanded his study to investigate sexuality in Escherichia coli. But these are stories for another day.